Hello friends, happy Independence Day. Today I'm joined by some of country music's brightest talent, all independent recording artists deeply affected by the pandemic. And they're here to help us celebrate the founding of this great nation. My guests include two established entertainers, one up-and-coming artist, and a country music legend, and all from the banks of one of Tennessee's most treasured landscapes. So, you're not going to want to miss a minute of this. Sit right down. Don't you go nowhere.
Switching sides and standing up for things they believe in. When they're running down my country, man, they're walking on the fighting side of me. They're walking on the fighting side of me. Running down the way of life, our fighting men are falling, dying key. If you don't love it, leave it, let this song I'm singing be a warning. When they're running down my country, man, they're walking on the fighting side of me. We read about some squirrely guy who claims that he just don't believe in fighting. And I wonder just how long the rest of us can count on being free. They love our milk and honey, but they preach about some other way of living. When they're running down my country halls, they're walking on the fighting side of me. Yeah, walking on the fighting side of me. Running down the way of life, our fighting men are falling by the key. If you don't love it, leave it, let this song I'm singing be a warning. When they're running down my country, man, they're walking on the fighting side of me. When they're running down my country house, they're walking on the fighting side of me.
My first guest on our special is a multi-talented bluegrass musician and entertainer. He's also the host of the hit online show, Banjos for Breakfast, performing that patriotic classic, Washington and Lee Swing. Here's Tracy Latham. Thank you. folks, Mike Hoffman. That was the Washington and Lee Swing. And, man, we have got the guy that just played that for you sitting here. Here's Tracy Latham, everybody. Good to see you, Tracy.
Hey, good to see you too, Mike.
Yeah.
Thanks for having me.
Yes, sir. We're proud that you have joined in with us for this 4th of July celebration. Tell me something. You know, people have focused on a lot of different things, been forced to, really, this whole past year with the pandemic situation. And how have you been? Hopefully you and your family are doing well. And what have you done to make adjustments with this pandemic and restriction just so you can go on with your show and keep things flowing?
Well, I try not to touch my face as much, you know. And as far as, you know, the restrictions that we've had, I've just had there used to be a book, and I never read it, but it's a good idea. It's called Who Moved My Cheese, you know.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what happened with the pandemic and the lockdowns and everything back in the spring of last year. And I had you know, bookings as a visual artist, that where I draw caricatures as an entertainer.
Right.
And also you know, a regular gig that I was doing at a little coffee shop and bakery here locally, calling it Banjos for Breakfast.
Right.
And I streamed that on Facebook Live as well, you know, as building up a local audience. And then COVID-19 shut all that down. And as far as the music part of it goes, I simply continued to stream it live on Facebook. I just created a little setting here in my pick and nook, you know, here in the old woodshed, and continued to go live on Facebook every week, and I've never quit. And I started a YouTube channel for it, and, you know, just continue to develop it.
This guy's not only a multi-talented instrumentalist, but he's also a caricature artist. And leading into this, as the pandemic restrictions continue to lift, what can we expect to hear and see from Tracy Latham? You had mentioned to me earlier that you've got a one particular thing that I found fascinating. You've got a gig coming up. It's a 3-day thing coming up where you're going to be able to use several of your talents at one place. So tell us a little about that.
Well, I'm in negotiations, and I think it's a done deal by now to do 3 days at Busch Gardens.
Yep.
At SeaWorld there, and in Virginia. And I'm going to be doing Banjos for Breakfast on stage, on a little stage out there somewhere.
Sure.
You know, out in the open. And, you know, it's not that big a deal, really, but it's a big deal to me, because you know, pushing it online and everything, I'm finally starting to book some gigs and get out. So I'm very excited about it, and especially, you know, that it's in a place like that. The only thing I'm not excited about is the 10-hour drive, you know.
Well, you got to get there. I figured you just hop in that Learjet that you've got and just fly on right on out there.
Well, I would, but the tires are flat on that thing, and I just hadn't had a chance to plug them.
I hear you. Good deal. Real quickly, I want to ask you about something else that you've accomplished that I find fascinating. There is a school there that you have went into their studio and you laid down multiple tracks. And for people, if you don't know what we're talking about with that, Tracy plays several instruments, and so he started out I think putting some banjo down, then you did some mandolin work, then you did some dobro, some harmonica, then you ended up putting some guitar on there. But he wound up playing, I believe it was the old Hank Williams song, I Saw the Light. and they have now incorporated that into one of their radio shows. Is that correct?
Yeah, it's at Mount Pleasant High Middle School in Mount Pleasant, Tennessee, there in Murray County. They have quite an interesting thing going on. They have sort of a liberal arts, a fine arts program for kids. They can study dance, studio recording. They can study visual arts and all those types of things there. Mm-hmm. It's really a progressive little school for such a little country town.
Sounds like it. Well, so while we're on that subject, tell us how and where the tons of fans and friends that you have, and the ones that you haven't even reached yet, how and where that those folks can find you and enjoy your music.
Well, there are two ways. You can find it through my social media on Facebook, and I have banjosforbreakfast.com will get you there. So frontporchpicker.com, if you go there, you can find a link to my YouTube channel.
Right.
So banjosforbreakfast.com or frontporchpicker.com. Either one of those URLs will get you, you can find me. So if you're interested, why, check it out. If not, why, I don't blame you.
If you didn't, friends, if you didn't have time to write that down as he was telling you, and it was, while it was on the screen, we will also be running this information on how to contact Tracy and listen to his music and continue to enjoy all that he has to offer. That will be in the credits at the end of the show. So, Tracy, man, I appreciate so much that you being here with me today and being part of this 4th of July celebration and sharing your talents with fans and friends. And with me, I'm both. I'm a fan and a friend. So,
that feeling's mutual, Michael. I'm a fan of yours too, and we're friends, and I'm glad of it. I appreciate your little videos that you put out of you singing gospel songs and good old country songs, and playing good rhythm on that fine Martin guitar you got laying back there in the background.
Yeah, it's with me about anywhere I go. So
yeah, it's a good companion.
All right. Well, folks, stay tuned. We're about to lead into another segment. This is the first of three parts of what I just simply call the history of Goldfoot Lake. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Thanks, Tracy.
Thank you, Michael. Take care.
All right. Welcome to Goldfoot Lake, Tennessee's only naturally made lake. This sportsman's paradise has incredible fishing, scenic picturesque views, and incredible locally owned mom-and-pop businesses. But this lake has not always been a part of the American landscape. Travel back with us to the early days of America. James Madison is president. The settlers are beginning to explore the recent Louisiana Purchase, a deal made by Thomas Jefferson. Some begin to settle in to the old Spanish settlement of New Madrid, located on the northern section of the New Madrid Bend. What these settlers did not realize at the time was that they were settling on one of America's most dangerous fault lines. The New Madrid seismic zone became active on December 16, 1811. The ground shook, and some villages, such as Little Prairie, were destroyed by soil liquefaction. After a series of 7.0 magnitude earthquakes during December and January, a large 8.6 magnitude quake struck at 3:45 a.m. on February 7, 1812. Some parts of the ground lifted along the mighty Mississippi, causing large waterfalls. Inland, the ground sank dramatically, causing obstructive streams and a reverse current on the river.
The power of the quake was felt across the continent. Church bells rang in Boston, and bricks were damaged in Toronto. As water filled into the large forested area, Real Foot Lake formed and resulted. But that is not the story that Native Americans told. Where Real Foot Lake now exists was once a Native American village guided by a young, ambitious Chief Real Foot. The chief was named for his foot, which was deformed from a childhood injury. When he became chief, he insisted on marrying a Choctaw princess that lived downriver near today's Memphis, Tennessee. Chief Real Foot sought her father's permission to marry her. However, the Choctaw king had no desire for his daughter to marry a small chief with such a physical deformity, and thus he was rejected. Upon arriving back home, Chief Real Foot was determined he needed the princess to be his wife. He set out with a team to kidnap her. However, according to legend, the Great Spirit warned the chief that if he were to kidnap the young girl, it would destroy all his people. As the story continues, the chief disobeyed. As he arrived back to his homeland with his princess, the Great Spirit grew angry and stomped his foot on the ground, causing the earthquake, the lake, and burying his new bride, the chief, and all of his people under the waters that now bear his name. The result of these earthquakes is the beauty you see today, a large lake lined by gorgeous bald cypress trees, a mostly peaceful landscape. Later, we will talk about how man's violence nearly destroyed this landscape.
Our next guest is an old friend of mine from my Nashville days. He's a talented singer, songwriter, and country musician whose tour, For the Love of Cash, will be traveling nationwide this year. Please welcome my old friend, Gary West. Our next guest for our celebration is an up-and-coming new country artist whose first song today hits very close to home. Performing his single, Go Get My Angel, introducing Jay Black.
Lay there on the bed and she just cried, as her mother held her little hands, wiped the tears from her eyes. Then the little girl smiled as if the same. Mama, I know everything's gonna be okay. Know that my life's been mostly pain. I haven't seen the sunshine much, it's been mostly rain. Last night as I slept, I had a dream, and I saw God as He handed Jesus my wings, and He said, go get my angel, bring them home to me. Yeah, they've had their share of pain, I'm gonna set them free. Even though they started broken, they're gonna be okay, because there's beautiful fighters like them. Make up my bouquet. I'll never forget that September day, standing in the hall alone, when I heard a voice break, say, I just called to let you know, my baby's got her wings, Lord carried her away. Just before she closed her eyes, I heard her say, hey mommy, daddy, it's time for me to go. 'Cause I just heard God tell someone, bring my angel home. And He said, go get my angel, bring them home to me. Yeah, they've had their share of pain, I'm gonna set them free. Even though they started broken, they're gonna be okay, because it's beautiful fighters like them that make up my bouquet. And even they started broken, they're gonna be okay, because it's beautiful fighters like them that make up God's bouquet.
There's homeless on the streets of every city, big city crime in every little town. There's people making money off of Jesus, and taxes dragging everybody down. There's politicians shredding up the truth, and farmers being pulled up by their roots, and
and pushers telling little kids that hide's the only way. Oh, welcome to the USA today. Well, it's true we've got our problems. Lord knows we make mistakes. And every time we solve one, 10 others take its place. But you don't see those refugees heading the other way. Oh, welcome to the USA today. But you know there's 1,000 happy homes for every homeless. Opportunity still knocks on every door. Our younger generation's really shining, much brighter than they've ever shone before. We've got the right to vote our leaders in. Oh, and we've got the right to vote them out. And we're all free to speak our minds and not get locked away. Oh, welcome to the USA today. Well, it's true we've got our problems. Lord knows we make mistakes. And every time we solve one, 10 others take its place. But you don't see those refugees heading the other way. Oh, welcome to the USA today. Oh, welcome to the USA today.
My next guest is no stranger at all to the road, to the music industry, to recording, to writing, you name it, he's done it and still doing it. He's out there promoting good, solid country music, and so we want to make welcome Mr. Gary West. Thanks for being with us.
Hey, thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, man. They've already heard you sing, I think, Ring of Fire. And so we got an extra special treat coming up after this with Gary and a special guest. But the 25th Academy of Western Artists, you've had several nominations: Pure Country Male, Pure Country Album, Pure Country Duo with Leona Williams, and then Pure Country Song of the Year with Leona Williams with Jackson. And congratulations, man, on all that.
Well, thank you very much. That's quite an honor any time you get recognized on something like that. We sure appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, tell me a little bit about how you're doing and what you've been up to. You know, this pandemic really has put a hurt on a lot of particularly independent artists. Major label artists, I'm not trying to downplay it, you know, for them, but a lot of those folks could afford to miss a few dates. You know, yeah. But independent artists have struggled a lot. And so how have you adjusted? I know a lot of people that I've talked to, they've focused on songwriting. They've been in the studio doing session work or recording albums. You know, tell us a little bit about how Gary West has adjusted to the pandemic and the restrictions.
Well, I probably haven't adjusted the same way a lot of people have, but it's been devastating, I gotta say that. You know, the last show that we did actually was with Leona Williams, and we had the release party for Jackson at the Nashville Palace in Nashville. Yeah. As we were coming back from our Florida tour, and we'd planned on doing a radio tour and so forth, and I was gonna come home for a couple weeks, which I did, and the pandemic hit, and that was really, that's the last concert that we actually performed. So we're looking forward to getting back out there now. And
one of the guys that plays for you is an old buddy of mine, Glenn Dickerson,
And, yes, sir.
And you can't beat Glenn. He's a good fella, and he's a hot picker. That's for sure.
Absolutely, he's a fantastic guy, a great player, and we have a lot of fun. We have a lot of fun with Glenn. We like to pick on him.
Well, do a little for me next time you're out there, okay?
Absolutely, we'll do it.
You're talking about your releases now. You guys released a much anticipated original song called "I Don't Do It for the Money, I Do It for the Love of Cash," and that was released back in October, wasn't it?
Yes, sir. Yeah, that was the song. I kind of a response to everybody asking me why I do all this Johnny Cash music, you know. And but it's a fun song, and it was I wrote that about. The day before we were supposed to go in the studio, I had everything kind of laid out what we were going to do, and Glenn had the charts on everything. And the day before we went in the studio, I sent them all text to every one of them, and I said, "Scratch all that, I'm redoing it." And I'd written two songs for the album and included those in there, and we really kind of completely redid everything for the album. So
it paid off for you because it went number one on the independent charts. During the month of February of this year, and it was your second number one, I believe, off of the latest album. So, congratulations.
Well, thank you very much.
Well, we talked a little bit about the pandemic, but as these restrictions begin to lift, and I know that they tend to lift and go back, but eventually the lifting, maybe at a slower rate, but the lifting is going to continue to expand, and there's going to be more freedoms. You guys are going to be back on the road. I know you're looking forward to that. I know that your band's looking forward to that, and I know the fans are looking forward to that. But tell us, what can we as fans and friends expect to hear and see from Gary West as the pandemic restrictions are lifted? What can we expect to hear and see?
We're starting to, you know, rebook things. A lot of things got canceled, moved forward, and it's pretty chaotic as far as booking and our dates. And you know, something we'd like to we're adding this year is some of the things from the Million Dollar Quartet with, you know, Jerry Lee and Carl Perkins and Elvis and
sure.
And you know, we have a lot of things that intertwine with Johnny Cash. Our show's not just Johnny Cash music, so we've always kind of did some things from the Highwaymen. So this year, I think that's going to be one of the fun aspects of it is adding some of the stuff from the Million Dollar Quartet to our show. And you might even catch me trying to play the piano some. So we'll see how that works
out. All right.
But looking forward to that. And we got some outside concerts, big shows coming up, and over 4th of July weekend, actually.
Well, I have seen excerpts from your show. And I've never had the opportunity to come and see you guys live, but I've seen excerpts from your show. And for those of you out there that haven't seen their show, you really need to go and see them and support them because they will certainly entertain you. It's a highly electric show. They have fun, and I just enjoy seeing you guys play every time that I can pick up on an excerpt. So I would certainly encourage the folks to come out and see you.
Well, thank you very much. It's pretty spontaneous.
Well, how and where can the fans and friends find you and enjoy your music?
Well, you know, you can pretty much Google me and find me in all the digital download places, but we always invite you to come to our website. It's GaryWestMusic.com, and there's videos there. There's, of course, all of our albums there you can download, or you can order the CDs from there. So always come to our website. That way you can find out where we're going to be playing and new information, and we try to keep it updated, you know, every week with new things. So always just come to visit our website at GaryWestMusic.com, and you can find anything you need there.
Good deal. Gary, I appreciate so much you being on the program, and if you enjoyed Ring of Fire, hold on to your hat, because the next song that's coming up is actually right after this interview is going to be Gary West and special guest Leona Williams in the studio together recording Jackson, the old Johnny Cash and June Carter song. And boy, did you guys do a super job on that.
Well, thank you. It was really an honor. I mean, everybody always said, oh, it was an honor. But I, being with Liliana Williams in the studio and getting a chance to do that with her, I just, she's one of the most wonderful people I've ever known. And I'm just grateful that she thought enough of me to, that she would record that with me. And we had a lot of fun, and she's a sweet lady. She did an amazing job. You know, I can remember as a young person in my teens, in my room playing drums, you know, to her and Merle Haggard singing. You know, I never thought I would be singing with her. So,
sure.
It truly is an honor to have her as a friend and to be able to record a song with her.
Well, she's a good singing partner, a good songwriter, and sounds like a good lady. I've never had the opportunity to meet her, but I'm certainly proud that you did, because you guys
she's a beautiful person.
You guys did a wonderful job. And without going any further with this, thanks again, and we're going to lead right into you and Miss Leona singing Jackson. How does that sound?
Sounds great. Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate what you're doing for all of us independent artists and all your efforts you put into this. You don't have to do this, so we truly are grateful for all your efforts and everything you do. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Thank you. All right, man. We'll see you.
Have a good day. Take care.
You too.
Bye-bye.
We got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out. Well, I'm going to Jackson. I'm gonna mess around. Yeah, I'm going to Jackson. Look out, Jackson Town.
Well, go on down to Jackson. Go ahead and wreck your health. Go play your hand, you big talking man, and make a big fool of yourself. Yeah, go on to Jackson. Go comb your hair.
I'm on a snowball in Jackson.
We'll see if I care.
When I breeze into that city, people gonna stoop and bow.
Huh.
All them women gonna make me teach them what they don't know how. Well, I'm going to Jackson. You turn loose of my coat. Honey, I'm going to Jackson.
Goodbye, that's all she wrote.
Foot Lake History, Part 2. Fast forward nearly 100 years. The lake region has gone from simple forested hunting grounds for pioneers such as Davy Crockett to an area that has experienced countless floods. One significant flood caused the Mississippi River to form a new route. The remains of that route are now known as the Washout, a popular recreational boating area notably without any of the cypress trees or stumps that dot the lake's landscape. A group of settlers made the banks of the lake their home, many of them living off the land, fishing the lake. It was common for commercial fishermen to be very possessive of the land grants permitted to them during the early days of settlement. The two main industries of the inhabitants were farming and fishing. Death threats were made by commercial fishermen and farmers to those wishing to harvest the precious woods in and near the lake. One local landowner decided to take advantage of an escalating situation. J.C. Harris was Lake County's biggest landowner and saw a business opportunity to purchase and drain the 15,000-acre swamp and uncover rich farmland. As Harris began to purchase, some landowners refused to sell and turned to more violent methods. Over a seven-month period, 100 known crimes were carried out. People were beaten and whipped, buildings set on fire, and crops were burned. The final straw took place in the Walnut Log area. On October 18, 1908, a posse of masked men called Night Riders attacked the famed Ward Hotel in Walnut Log, Tennessee. Kidnapped were two guests, both attorneys and both minority stakeholders in the West Tennessee Land Company, now the sole owners of Realfoot Lake. The two men, Quentin Taylor and R.Z. Rankin, were marched to the nearby Bayou de Chien, the former river that serves as an entryway to the lake. Rankin was hung and shot by the 15 to 20 masked men. Taylor escaped by swimming from the Obion County side to the Lake County side of the lake. He was found the next day disoriented and wandering the countryside. Governor Malcolm Patterson activated the State Guard and personally led them to Realfoot Lake. The murder at the lake was the final straw with politicians in Nashville. After detaining and interviewing hundreds, the governor turned his attention to only eight individuals, including my own great-grandfather, Bob Hoffman. Initially, six of the eight were found guilty of first-degree murder, and the other two men were found guilty of second-degree murder. However, the Supreme Court of Tennessee later overrode their convictions on a constitutional technicality. 4 months later, a new legal battle began for the state to own and preserve the lake. In 1914, the lake was freed and declared for the public good. This is easily linked to the beginning of the state park movement in Tennessee. Much has happened since then. Stay tuned. Later in the special, you can find out what Realfoot offers today.
Hello, folks. Michael Hoffman and my next guest. You've already heard him sing one song for you, Go Get My Angel. He's going to be performing another one right after this interview, but my next guest is from West Kentucky, and I've already dubbed him the West Kentucky Heartthrob, but his name is Jay Black. Welcome, Jay.
Thank you for having me.
Sure. Listen, the pandemic that we've been going through, particularly all of last year, really set some musicians and singers and songwriters back quite a bit with their inability to travel and perform and so forth. Many of them found ways to adapt. They wound up doing more songwriting, or they wound up doing more session work, or they went in and worked on projects, albums, and so forth. But tell us a little bit about how you've been and what it's kind of been like to go through this pandemic for you, and how you've adjusted to the pandemic and the restrictions that have been put on us.
Oh, yeah. My story is a little bit different. Of course, I went in last year around November. I was cutting an album down in Nashville.
Mm-hmm.
And, we got all the music and everything ready, and I was going to go lay down my vocals starting in February. And on February 19th, my daughter, at 3 years old, got diagnosed with stage 4 high-risk neuroblastoma cancer. Of course, we lost Lennon September 25th after a long battle.
I'm very, very, very sorry for your loss. I kept up with it through social media and when you would post things about it, and I'm still profoundly sorry for your loss.
I appreciate it. You know, the only thing I can do now is trust in the Lord and keep pushing forward and bring awareness to childhood cancer. It's just been put on the back burner for so long. And, you know, I feel like that's my calling. Just like this album that I'm coming out with, every little thing that we make off this album is going toward just the research. And
the research is where it's at.
Yeah. I felt that, you know, God gave me a gift, and I need to use it for the good.
Well, I commend you for that, because so many people, being honest, I can say that I don't know how I would react at the loss of a child. Some people, you know, the old saying is that you either get better or you get bitter. And you've chosen, and that's a choice that you have made. That's not something that just comes naturally. You have chosen to try to make things better, try to take a bad situation and try to help improve the lives of so many other people, and so I commend you for that.
Thank you.
Well, tell me, as the restrictions are lifted, and you know, we everything keeps kind of going back and forth with this. They lift them and then they put them back, and they lift them and they put them back. But as people continue to get vaccinated and they continue to actually research this to, you know, to see what the next chapter is with this. But as they lift these, hopefully on a permanent basis, and they do this slowly, what can we as fans and friends expect to hear and see from Jay Black?
Well, I'm working right now with a few people, and I want to go to all 50 states. That is my main goal right now. I want to go to all 50 states, and I'm going to call it the More Than Four Tour. You know, just play, you know, just one place, you know, in a main city. I don't care if there's four or five people watching, but or in the crowd that ain't never heard of Jay Black, but a lot of people don't know about the More Than Four. You know, a lot of people don't know that childhood cancer research from the federal government, we only get 4%, while adults get 96% of funding.
So, as far as what we can expect to hear, what I'm hearing is that you have a plan to visit a lot of different places and try to carry your message on the road, and continue with your pursuit of increasing awareness for childhood cancer.
Yep. Yes, sir.
Good deal. Well, tell me this: what is the? You've mentioned a couple of times that there's an album. What's the name of the album?
Well, I think we're going to go with I Lived It.
Okay.
It's just basically a song off the album that I wrote. It's about farming and the hardships about farming.
For your fans and your friends, tell us where, how, and where we might be able to go to find you and enjoy your music.
Well, I'm going to tell you this. If you just look up Jay Black Music, you can find me pretty much on all platforms.
Okay.
But on Facebook, it's just Jay Black Music. And on YouTube, it's Jay Black Music. Of course, I have the liberty of sharing the name of another singer in the 70s. Jay Black and
I saw that. I saw that. Yeah. Well, friends, this is Jay Black. Jay, I appreciate you being with us today, and appreciate your strength and your honesty and your mission, and you know, trying to combine a gift that God's given you through music, trying to combine that with raising awareness for so many people that are in need. It just don't get no better than that. So, again, I appreciate you being here with us, and the best of luck to you in your mission and in your music and in your album. I've lived it. We wish you all the success, you know, with that. Jay Black, ladies and gentlemen. Jay, again, thank you.
I appreciate it.
All right, man. Take care.
It pours, but you didn't even notice. It ain't raining anymore. It's hard to breathe when all you know is the struggle of staying above the rising waterline. Well, the sky's finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. You hold tight to your umbrella, darling, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. If you could see what I see, you'd be blinded by the color. Yellow, red, and orange, and green, and at least a million others. So tie up your bow, take off your coat, and take a look around. 'Cause the sky's finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. You hold tight to your umbrella, girl, I'm just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. Hold tight up your bow, take off your coat and take a look around. Everything is alright now. 'Cause the sky's finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but you're stuck out in the same old storm again. You hold tight to your umbrella, just trying to tell you that there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. Yeah, there's always been a rainbow hanging over your head. If you're going through anything at all,
welcome everyone. Mike Hoffman back with you again. We have run across a gold mine here. We have had time to sit down with one of the busiest men that I know in the Real Foot Lake region, Mr. Mike Hayes.
Good to
good to see you. Appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedule to sit down with us and talk to us a little bit about Blue Bank.
Oh, I appreciate you coming. Anybody come try to help this area, I'm all for them.
Well, we're all for real foot tourism. And you have a beautiful place here.
For those of you that have not been here to see it, you've got to come see it. It's lit up at night like Christmas. I mean, it's just so pretty out there. And then during the daytime, we actually got here a little early before Mr. Hayes got here, and we took walks in the garden out front and got some photo shots that we're showing you probably now as we talk. But just beautiful, beautiful landscaping. And that's not even a tenth of what he's got to offer here. Tell us about, this is a family-owned business, I know, but tell us about Blue Bank Resort and its impact on tourism when it comes to Real Foot Lake.
My family, we've been here over 100 years, five generations. You know, my son's starting in right now. And it's always been a big part of life. You know, my father taught me that I'm responsible not only to help grow my business, but, you know, help the whole lake. You know, try to help the whole lake as a whole. And I hope that we've been a big part of that in the past and doing our part to bring in tourism to West Tennessee.
And this is five generations?
Five generations. Back in the late 1800s, my great-grandfather, George Davis, was taking people out, you know, on boat tours and different things. Then in the 1920s, my grandmother opened up one of the first hotel restaurants, kind of like a bed and breakfast. And she started in the 1920s, and we grew from there. We're not in the same location, but we got the same kind of concept. They're bringing tourists in, hunting, fishing, a little bit of everything. And since then, we've kind of evolved and been more of a resort and expanded to take care of not only the fisherman hunter, but their families and, a little bit of everybody to be a rural resort. You know?
Sure.
The market's really changing, fishing and hunting. What I could do 10 years ago, you got to do a lot more, you know. You fishermen that's growing, I call them resort fishermen. You know, they got to have more. They got, the Discovery Park, they need a place, for dinner, they need entertainment, they need activities. You know, I've been started doing wine tasting events, do fireworks, Christmas events. I'm doing a lot more to bring a whole different type of person that'll come to the fishing hunting industry.
I remember a time that some old friends of mine back at the Opry used to come down.
We've always had a lot of people from Nashville, the entertainers from Porter Wagner to little Jimmy Dixon to
Grandpa Jones.
All of them used to come. Yep. And to this day, we still have a lot of them coming, but I can't really publicize it because they come here to get away.
I'd
give anything when they're here if they let me push them, whatever. But, you know, they come here to get away and everyone enjoy it.
That kind of defeats their purpose, I guess, if you publicize it. So yeah. What other things are available to people that would like to come to Real Foot Lake, but they're not really sure what all this region offers?
Well, there's several things. See, I started trapping moat, not just Real Foot, but within probably about an hour area.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the Discovery Park, it's amazing. It's a one of a kind. It's a world-class attraction. It's on 40 acres. The Kirklands, they donated about $100 million and left an endowment to help run it. It's spectacular. It's nothing like it. It's as nice a museum-type, school-related work. I mean, it got everything.
Yeah.
And
very
you compete with that for anything in the United States with Real Foot. And both of them together, you got two main attractions. You know, within Real Foot, you know, we got several shops and some really neat soap making factories. There's a brewery, Full Throttle, just put in a brewery making their whiskey with, right in Newbern. We got to have a safari park. It's about 45 minutes from here on the way to Jackson. And it's really bringing some people in. Now they got a big drive-in theater. That's there, that outdoor
that
at night. That's become a big attraction.
We were coming back from the Jackson area just this past weekend. I noticed they were publicizing they had a drive-in.
As far as ecotourism, there's no other place like it, with the wildlife, the birds, the eagles. Real Foot, lower 48 United States, Real Foot has more nested and bald eagles than one in the United States. The ducks, the everything, you don't have to be a duck hunter to come enjoy it.
That's right.
You know, the wildfowl we got, it's here several years out, you know, months out of the year. So you need to come see that. Kayaking, there's no other place better to kayak than Real Foot. You can get back there in some of them swamp areas. There's trees that you can't believe. There's one out there, I bet 16 foot in diameter. It's beautiful. There's a lot of nature that here that you get back and enjoy that you don't even think about.
Right, right. Well, a lot of people are not aware that there are also things to do during the off season.
Right.
And so what do you offer?
Well, all through the year this year, we got a weekend where we're doing an arts and craft. That's in addition to the big one in the fall. We're developing arts and craft in a middle of June that bring in some really good craft makers. You know, I'm trying to make it where it's real craft maker and not bringing stuff shipped in from somewhere. I do wine tasting events on weekend. I got butterfly weekend. We're bringing speakers and, you know, showcase our butterfly trail. At some time during the year, I can have over 3,000 to 5,000 migrating monarchs out here. This butterfly trail I built, 80% of it, everything I plan is track butterfly from monarchs to all different kinds. And I, you know, I plant over 3,000 milkweed plants every year, tropical, just to make sure on top of other things I'm planting to bring it in. Last year, or 2 years ago, a photographer spotted a black-tailed moth that's the first one ever been photographed in Tennessee. And it was shot right out here.
Yeah.
So, right here, I'm trying to do events at least every other weekend during the summer month. I'm looking to bring in a chef weekend where I have a different chef come each weekend around the United States and do different type of special for me. And I'm going to try and incorporate that to what we'll be having some cooking class with professional chefs throughout the summer.
Oh, that'd be neat.
There's a lot of new things we're working on. I have a new PR person working with me on, and we're really going to be set up for corporate retreats. I met with a guy last night that just put a shooting range in. He's going to have 2 F for sport clay, trout, professional trout, Olympic type deal where it's going to be a professional type place, and we're working on a detail down, and we're going to be announcing the package we're going to be doing together just this next week.
Oh, okay. We'll look forward to that.
Okay.
Yeah. Good deal. Well, and I'm going to step back just a little bit. Those are some really, really, really neat, modernized type things to meet the needs of folks. But there's still a market. Even though it's changed quite a bit, you were telling me there's still a market for the traditional hunter and fisherman.
Oh yeah,
and you guys offer multiple packages.
Yeah, we do all type of packages, hunting and fishing. My fishing package, most of the time, average price is around $369 a year. That includes your boat, motor, bait, gas, ice, lodging. On weekend, you get 3 nights, 4 days, and during the week, what I do, it's the same price, but I throw in an extra day and night, so it's actually a 4-night, 5-day package.
Can't beat that.
It includes your boat, motor, bait, gas, ice, lodging, and one of the main guys on Real Foot, Billy Blakey, my head pro, he'll be out here every morning. You can ask him where to fish. He's here just set up to help people have a better experience at Real Foot. So I feel like for our fishing, we got something to offer that we're really trying to help people fish. We're not trying to make money off the guy. We're trying to get people here to show them where to fish.
Right.
Now, we do have a first-class guide service. One of my main guides, Jeff Rill, he won a national championship tournament, and he recognized one of the best crappie fishermen in America, him and Tony Hughes. And then when we come to our duck hunting, that's a tradition been going on forever at Real Foot. You know, we do packages. We do a 3-day, 3-night package. It's guided. It's lodging, food, everything included for around right $950 a person.
Yeah.
It goes up $100 on weekend and $100 lower on during the week. But
when you consider that's all inclusive.
Yeah, it's all inclusive. What I try to do here, you know, if you got a group of hunters come in here and they pay the package, you know, I got firewood for them, no charge. I try to give you the price and don't have any extras you have to pay when you come here.
Right.
I want you to No, when you come here, this is what you get, and you have a good time for the price I gave you.
Well, for the people that are that have heard this and they're interested in contacting you guys, how do they contact you?
Oh, we just call 1-877-BLUE-BANK. And the number on that will be, always get mixed up on, 1-877-258-3226. That's our toll-free number, 1-877-BLUE-BANK.
You can see that on the bottom of the screen, too,
yep,
just in case. Any other, what about social media?
Social media, I think we got one of the best Facebook pages in the country for hunting and fishing. We put up everyday posts of what's going on. We put what we got coming up. We got any packages on it. We put daily catches up on every single day. So if you know, Blue Bank Resort, Facebook page, check it out, join, and you can see exactly what we have to offer every day at Real Foot.
Well, Mike, I appreciate your time. You've given us a lot of information, and I think you're going to see that a lot of people are interested. You've already got a lot of people interested, but just hopefully this will spur up some more. We can enhance the experience of tourism at Real Foot Lake.
If you ever want to come back, set up a fishing trip. I can really take y'all out and do a fishing segment. Anytime you want to come, just holler at me and I'll set something up for you. We can look at different things we're doing. I'm glad to have you anytime you want to.
Man, I appreciate you very much. All right. Mike Hayes, owner and proprietor of Blue Bank Resort on the scenic Real Foot Lake. And speaking of scenic Real Foot Lake, this takes us into our final segment on the history of Real Foot Lake. So don't you go nowhere. Real Foot Lake History, Part 3. In this special, you have discovered the birth of Real Foot Lake and its reign of terror brought by the Night Riders. Now we turn our attention to the modern-day Real Foot Lake, what Real Foot Lake State Park offers, and which major Hollywood movie productions have been filmed at the Oasis. Real Foot Lake State Park offers much to visitors. At the Visitor Center, guests enjoy an extended scenic boardwalk. Caged raptor birds like the great American bald eagle, hawks, and owls. They can also visit the R.C. Donaldson Museum, a free attraction where guests can learn more about the lake region and the brand new Great River Roads Visitor Center. The park also offers attractions such as two large campgrounds, beautiful cabins near the historic Spillway Bridge, and access for boating and fishing. Additionally, a new youth ninja course offers great fun for children of all ages. Outside of the state park, visitors can travel to the Real Foot Lake National Wildlife Refuge. At the refuge, one can hike and get up close to nature. Near the refuge in Walnut Log, visitors may recognize the background scenery from the film U.S. Marshals, starring Tommy Lee Jones. If you want to visit the lake, but are unsure of where to best spend your time on the water, the region offers many personal guides who will take you to the very best fishing and hunting spots. And when it's time to eat, Real Foot Lake offers some of the best restaurants in the entire southern United States. And if camping and roughing it just aren't your things, stop by one of the many hotels and resorts for a reasonably priced stay. Whether it's eagle watching, fishing or hunting, arts and crafts, a day hike, or an incredible meal, there is something for everyone in the region. Welcome to paradise. Welcome to Real Foot Lake.
My next guest is a decorated war veteran. At the age of 18, he joined the United States Army as a paratrooper, serving in Operation Desert Storm and Desert Shield. Today, he joins us to pay tribute to all the troops. Reading in part, Freedom Is Not Free by Kelly Strong, from Veterans Park in nearby Union City, Tennessee, here is Johnny Dyer.
Freedom Isn't Free by Kelly Strong. I watched a flag pass by one day. It fluttered in the breeze. A young Marine saluted. And then he stood at ease. I looked at him in uniform, so young, so tall, so proud. With hair cut square and eyes alert, he stood out in any crowd. I thought, how many men like him had fallen through the years? How many had died on foreign soil? How many mothers' tears? How many pilots' planes shot down? How many had died at sea? How many foxholes were soldiers' graves? No, freedom is not free. I heard the sound of taps one night when everything was still.
I listened to the bugler play and felt a sudden chill. I wondered just how many times that taps had meant amen when a flag had draped a coffin of a brother or a friend. I thought of all the children, of the mothers and the wives, of fathers, sons, and husbands with interrupted lives. I thought about a graveyard at the bottom of the sea, of unmarked graves in Arlington. No, freedom is not free. That's all the time we have for this celebration, folks. We want to thank all of the troops across the globe fighting to preserve this great republic. I also want to thank Mike Hayes and Blue Bank Resort for being such gracious hosts, Johnny Dyer for his service to our nation, and of course, Tracy Latham, Jay Black, Gary West, and the legendary Leona Williams. May God bless you and keep you safe, and until next time, don't you go nowhere.